Alright guys, welcome to the next part of the Final Fantasy X HD Remaster. So, last part, I told you guys I was going to farm these guys, and I did for right around 40-50 minutes, so basically if you still don't get what to do, just try to cast haste on one or two of your characters, if you have it. If you don't, that's fine, you don't need to. And go ahead and get, make sure Yuna and Lulu both get a turn, and then bring in Titus, Waka, and Kamari. I'm gonna be saying Titus this whole game. And then just go ahead and make sure Titus casts Cheer 5 times so you guys can one hit kill them like so. So there you go. And if you get an overkill, you get one more experience point. So yeah. Now, after that, what you're gonna do, you're gonna take out Kamari and Titus. And you're gonna start hammering that fin away. And I think this will be a good opportunity for me to get an overkill on that fin. Because Yuna does have Sensor, I also have Black Magic on Yuna, so this should be pretty quickly once he gets down to about 600-700 HP. I'm gonna bring in Valfor so we get that overkill and get some more EXP. So hopefully we'll get a lot of sphere levels after this. And Waka, of course, can still hit the fin. Nice critical right there. So they all suck. I just gotta have line 62. Alright, and Yuna's turn is next. I'll hit fire one more time. Then Yuna can bring in Valfor. Alright. He does have his overdrive, so should be good, man. Should be good. Here we go. Good, Valfor. Good. Alright, so let's get that. See, they're both deals non-elemental damage to play all enemies. Oh, I thought it was single attack. I am stupid. So, anyways, I thought it was to one enemy. I guess I might be thinking of something else. Oh well. So this is Energy Blast, the second overdrive you can learn, which is, it's much better because it has a stronger base damage than the Energy Ray. Boom. Overkill, 1436. Perfect. After you defeat the fin, that it's gonna end the battle. So let's see how much. Oh no, yeah, it's gonna show after. Okay. Enjoy this cutscene, guys. Alright, so we are now underwater getting attacked by more of these Sin Scale things. We get thrown overboard and then Waka just comes in here and gets the luckiest shot of his life. This guy is a god, yet he hasn't won a Blitzball game in 10 years. Like, what the hell? This kid can hit a freaking scale like 30 miles away from him and have the ball returned to him, but he hasn't won a Blitzball game in 10 years. This guy should be able to carry any team. So Titus is saying he's all good, and now we see dolphins flying by and another boss battle. So this could be a really difficult part of the game for, you know, first time players, because it's two consecutive bosses in a row with no save sphere or nothing in between. I can't use haste anymore because I already I don't have any more MP. So you do have a couple options. You could like cheer, and you know, cheer, or use it 5 times and then start attacking, which is probably what I'm gonna do. This boss has 2,000 HP, so you know he's not that deadly. But it could be a problem if you know you're kind of worn out from that first battle. So definitely want to get darkness on him. I'm gonna go with another cheer. This is gonna be number 2. Yeah, I could use an ether if I wanted to, and cast what's it called? Haste on both my guys, but that's not. I'm not gonna do that. Also, I got 2 new overdrive modes for Tidus, and I'm gonna show you them after we're done. So, speaking of overdrives, so let's use the spiral cut while we can. This actually should have saved it. Anyways, nice 700 right there. So, I'm not even gonna bother with the cheers now. Now I'm just gonna keep attacking him. By the way, don't bother hitting, trying to attack the scaled guys. So, there's just no point really. 184. 254. This guy's almost dead. Alright, this is his most powerful attack, Blender. Now, if he has darkness, he actually might miss this attack. Let's see. Now, we got hit. It's really rarely that he'll actually miss Blender, even with darkness. So, come on now. He's staying alive. And the reason you won't want to bother is as soon as these scales hit you, they're gonna generate. So, he's gonna take 46 HP. And there we go, that should be it. So that is it for this boss. Took care of it pretty quickly. I believe we're gonna see now how much experience I got from all that grinding, including this boss as well, so hopefully it'll be a nice amount. Let's see. Alright, nice. So about 7 to 8 levels. That's beautiful. That's exactly where I was thinking I'd get it. 99 power spheres. We won't need to worry about those, guys. A blue ring and a blue shield, which just contain water ward, a couple ability, and mana spheres. Okay.
When Sin attacked Xanarkand that day, I woke up in Spira. I kept hoping it would work in reverse, too.
I will defeat Sin. I must defeat Sin.
I was just fooling myself. Maybe it was that day, on the sea, under the burning sun. I started to give up hope. I was in a foreign world. I wasn't going home. This was my new reality, and I was stuck in it for good.
All right, so pretty emotional scene there. A lot of people just got, you know, their lives ruined. You know, the whole village is practically ruined. Apologize for that. That's my phone. So yeah, you know, not the best thing here. And damn that phone.
Greetings. I am the summoner Yuna. I have come from the temple in Bisaid.
Oh, Milady Summoner!
If there is no other summoner here, please allow me to perform the sending.
Ah, thanks, BT.
Our loved ones. We feared they would become fiends.
Please, take me to them.
All right, so Titus is all the way in the back. And,
we'll go see what we can do to help in town.
Indeed. So, you definitely want to save here. Actually, first, let's go ahead and get through these sphere levels. You got a nice amount, so to say. Okay, walk us here. What the f... Okay, yeah. Let's move him down here. Nice accuracy by 2. Got 99 power spheres from that guy, so... yeah, if you do this, like, with... If you have, like, a turbo controller or something, and you just leave it on and you go to school or where, you're gonna come back, you'll probably see 99 or, you know, at least in the 50s, I think. Not really sure if it's gonna be 99. Or he gets aim, which is basically cheer, except it boosts accuracy. So, again, he's getting random... freaking magic spheres, whatever. I don't get that, but now, Titus, my main man, Titus, strength by 1. Should have really gotten that earlier. What's down here? HP spheres, HP sphere, guard. It's tempting to go down there for just for the HP sphere, but I'm not going, so I'm gonna stick to his normal path. What's this? Extract speed. Is it really worth it? I'm not gonna bother. Not yet, at least. Not for extract speed. We're pretty fine on speed spheres. The only spheres you really ever don't have a lot of will be ability spheres. I have less mana. That's because when I was farming back in Visaid, I used extract ability on the flans most of the time, and instead of mana spheres, they dropped ability spheres. So could do this and activate provoke, a really helpful ability for a certain monster later on in the game. That could be very annoying. And mana by 20, so we're almost at what is this, delay attack. We're pretty early on here, so Yuna, let's just move her down to here, get her water spell. And let's move all the way here. Yes, indeed. It's magic defense by 3. Another MP. What the heck? Oh. Okay. Whatever. HP. Mana. Awesome. What's this? This should be focus. Okay, it is. Kamari. Now, Kamari is really interesting in the fact that, you know, he could really go anywhere. He doesn't have his own grid. So, you know, right here is like near Titus. Right here is, you know, Cure, and you know that's Yuna's, and then, you know, he's just in the middle. You could go really anywhere you want with him. But we are going to go. Which way are we gonna go? Let's see. I just went over this, and now I'm confused as hell. In this way, we're gonna take him. Okay, yeah. So what we're gonna do with Kamari, we're gonna go up through Tidus's, but then we're gonna drop off down here to Riku's grid. So I believe that's the only way. It's only a level 1 key sphere, and I think you get one fairly soon. I'm not sure if it'll be worth it to wait, but so basically we're gonna go first. Let's just pick up all this stuff. So scan, never really gonna use this. It's basically like putting in a permanent sensor. Oh, why did I go this way? Oh my gosh. What's this anyways? Jinx. I thought it was connected. I messed up there, my bad. I'm not really going to be using Kamari, I'm going to let you know, guys. He's probably just not even going to be used practically at all, so don't expect to see too much of him. Apologize for any Kamari fans, but he doesn't have a real, you know, big purpose. So Speed Sphere, Evasion by 4. Lulu has a lot of evasion, so now she's just going to be dodging everything at this point. And there's that phone again. Here's another evasion. And defense by 2. So I believe that's everyone. Yep. So we got a nice little boost and everything. So save the game. And now you're gonna go ahead and enjoy this very long cutscene. And then after that, I'm gonna end this video. So thank you guys for watching. Enjoy this cutscene. It's a pretty cool one in my opinion. And I'll see you guys on the next part.
What's ascending? Are we going somewhere?
You truly are clueless. Are you sure it's just your memory that's the problem? The dead need guidance. Filled with grief over their own death, they refuse to face their fate. They yearn to live on, and resent those still alive. You see, they envy the living. And in time, that envy turns to anger, even hate. Should these souls remain in Spira, they become fiends that prey on the living. Sad, isn't it? The sending takes them to the far plane, where they may rest in peace.
Summoners do this? It must be tough, being a summoner.
Yuna chose her own path. She knew, from the beginning, what it meant. All we can do is protect her along the way, until the end.
Until the end? What's the end?
Until she defeats Sin.
Oh.
I hope I did okay.
You did very well. They've reached the far plane by now, but no tears next time,
I wished there would never be a next time. No more people being killed by Sin. No more sendings for Yuna. Everyone stood there watching her. It was strange, and somehow, horrifying. I never wanted to see it again.